Welcome to Helen's Take on Preferences and Settings. So today we're going to take a look at what preferences and settings are, where you can find them, how you can change them, how you can share them, and how you can reset them in case things go a little bit wrong. So first up, let's take a look at where we can find them. So keyboard shortcuts, you want to use Command and Comma if you're on a Mac, or Control, Alt, and S if you are on Windows. So I'm on a Mac today, so I will use Command and Comma, and it will bring up the preferences. It will bring up settings on Windows. It's exactly the same. So first thing to note is there's quite a lot of groupings on the left-hand side. You can use your arrow keys, you can scroll down, you can drill into them if you want to. And it's worth, especially if you've not been in this dialogue before, it's worth just browsing around and getting a feel for how your preferences are grouped. However, when it comes to changing them, using your arrow keys is not the fastest way. So you can type directly into this dialogue. So for example, let's type in optimize imports. So now our search results are limited to just those that relate to our search criteria. I don't want to change the keyboard shortcut, so I'll keep looking through. That's the checkbox I want. I want to do this. So I'm going to select that checkbox. If you don't know what anything does, you can just hover over this question mark here and it will tell you what that option does, so you can decide if you want to configure it or not. What else can we search for? Let's search for code folding. Again, it's going to reduce the list of search results that are returned to just the stuff that you're interested in. Now, the option I want is their Java one-line methods. I've cleared that checkbox because I don't want my one-line methods to be folded. So I've changed a couple of settings. Let's click OK and see the change. So if you were quick, you notice two changes. Firstly, the import that I had, import java.util.hashset, I think it was, is gone because I selected optimize imports and I don't need that import. So IntelliJ IDEA has dealt with that. The other change that's happened is my methods have been expanded. They were one-line methods. They've now been expanded because I turned that option off. So that's what the settings are and where to find them. So remember Command and Comma on Mac or Control, Alt, and S on Windows. Next, what if you need to share those settings? So say you have a desktop machine and a laptop machine and they're both running IntelliJ IDEA and you want to have the same settings on each machine. Two ways of achieving that. First way, you can go File, Manage IDE Settings, and Export. So this will allow you to create a zip file of all the settings that you select, and you can change these if you want to, but by default, it will export all your settings. You can then go onto your other machine and File, Manage IDEs, Import Settings. So that's one way of doing it. If you're using IntelliJ IDEA Ultimate, which I am today, you'll also see this setting here, Sync Settings to JetBrains Account. So again, that's available in IntelliJ IDEA Ultimate, and that will allow you to sync your settings to your JetBrains account. So wherever you're logged in with that and you're using IntelliJ IDEA, your settings will be synced automatically. If you want to share your settings with your team members or your colleagues, perhaps you're all using IntelliJ IDEA and you want to keep the same settings across your code base, again, two ways of doing it. The first way is the one I've already shown you, so you can export and then all your colleagues can import, but that could get out of sync really, really quickly, especially if one person wants to make a change, that person has to export and then everybody else has to import. So the alternative way of doing it, and this is available in IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition, is with a settings repository. So you can select this, you can set an upstream URL in your version control system, and then everybody else can use that same settings repository on their machine so that all your settings will stay in sync automatically, which is really, really nice and can save you a lot of pain and hassle. So that's how you can share settings between your own instances of IntelliJ IDEA and with your wider team. Finally, what if you just want to reset them? And this can happen for a number of reasons. It might be that you're fairly new to the product and you've made some changes, you've had a good explore, but now you just want it back to how it was to start with so you can make some more sensible choices with your settings. In that instance, Again, it's File, Manage ID Settings, and it is Restore Default Settings. Now, just a word of warning, this will restore your default settings. It will restore anything within your settings dialog. For example, if I use Command and Comma again, and I go to GitHub. So my GitHub account is linked. If I was to restore all my settings, it would remove this as well. So just be aware when you restore your settings, it does restore your settings. It restores all of your settings. So that's it for today. We have gone through where to find them. So that is Command and Comma on Mac or Control, Alt and S on Windows. How to change them. So using the arrow keys, but better still, search for what you want to change. How to share them between your own instances of IntelliJ IDEA and your teammates, and then how to reset them. So I hope that was useful, and thanks for watching.